Good afternoon. Welcome back to the West Virginian State Wells. Well, Kentucky State Wells. We're like between of West Virginia and Kentucky State. Right now we're in Kenova, West Virginia. Looks like to be Lehigh Valley, coming second on a cold train, bound for Virginia or something. I don't know where this one's bound to, but it's going south on a coal train. Unexpected, first train in Kenova. Well, here comes another train. This one is an Intermodal. One of the Hotshots in Intermodals. It has a Kansas City Southern, dwelling third position. But, why did I even say Kansas City Southern? It's CPKC now. Kansas City Southern was the old name of Kansas City Southern. But now it's CPKC. But this one is on the Kenova district, just like the other one was. Here comes a CSX. We are on a big sandy junction. But the line that we are near is the big sandy. Well, I don't know what the other one is. But it goes through Huntington and stuff. Anyway, this is M317 from Cumberland to Cincinnati, Ohio. Here's the defect detector.
CSX detector, milepost 507.1, track main 1, no defect, repeat, no defect, total axles 520, detector out.
This train here is M653 from Wausaukee to Rocky Mount, North Carolina. It would go on to the Big Sandy, tell like Virginia and North Carolina and stuff. Yeah, it just has Gevo and then front and then rear. So, this will be the kind of the Big Sandy train's first one of the day. I will see a couple more of them on the end of the trip. Thank you. if you could tell in the distance, there comes another train from the other direction, north and south. This one's the northbound. N652 from Rocky Mount to Russell, Kentucky. But it would have a dash 8 trail in second. 7765, the Chessie system. It's not the Heritage, it's just a sticker. G759 just has GEs, but this is a grain train. But anyway, we are chasing it to West Huntington defect detector, since we are going out to eat in Huntington, West Virginia. We may as well get this one again. at the defect detector. Well, we have gone into the night. Before we go into our hotel rooms, here comes a southbound on the Russell subdivision. It would just be just engines, no cars or anything, which was kind of weird, but oh well. But I was at Superville earlier today, like this afternoon before I was down in Kenova and stuff. I saw a Mace with a Gevo, well, with coke cars. That was it, but without the coke cars.
You know what? That was the coal train.
Yeah.
Good morning, everybody. We're on a Russell subdivision for waiting PO 50. But we have a coal train that is going by. It's loaded, so it's kind of cool. Not expecting a coal train this early morning. I thought we would only get like Amtrak in the morning and then freight or whatever. But it's cool. I've never seen a coal train over here before. First time seeing one in this area. Alright, here comes Amtrak, the 050. After he would make his stop at Ashland's Kentucky station, now he would go by us. With just a normal P-42, but I don't see Amtrak much in my area. There goes M693 from Wausaukee to White Yard in Waycross, Georgia. I was not expecting that after eating some breakfast in the morning. Well, I was eating some breakfast at the hotel. And then after I got done eating breakfast, here goes M693. But now we're at RB Cabin and Louisa Kekki. CNO R2 signals will be still standing, but this is basically in the middle of nowhere. Thank you. Alright, now we're on a Kenova district. We have a southbound manifest. This is probably 18M with two NS aces and one C6M. I'm guessing this is 18M. Alright, here comes another southbound on the Kenova district. This one is a coal train. Well, I have no clue if this one's combined, but man, he had like a lot of engines. Just the two up front, and the other two as a mid DPU. But if I ever see any changes on this train, I'll let you guys know. But so far, this is probably loaded or empty. It's hard to tell if it's loaded or empty. But anyway, he's going south on the Kenova district. Thank you. I was about to get, we were about to get ready to go back to Kenova, West Virginia, till the gates were going down, and that's what I noticed. There goes the northbound, so I don't know what the symbol on this one is, but it had two engines on front, and then one as the middle. There it goes. 43 series. Wow. Nice and shiny. Well, after getting at the crossing, the end went by, and then we went to Neal, West Virginia, just south of Kenova. Neal is actually a control point on the Kenova district. We made it to Neal, the control point, just south of Kenova, West Virginia. And we made it 3 minutes to spare within from Neal. I don't know what that one crossing was, just north of Fort Gay, West Virginia. What good there? There looks like there's a train on the Big Sandy subdivision. Camera angle looks so bad. I literally got done shooting an ass and there goes the coal train on the Big Sandy. But here comes a southbound Intermodal. Looks like it's a solo AC-44 C6M that's leading the Intermodal. But there is a surprise at the mid-DPU. Well, I'm gonna say it anyway. It's a UP and an NS at the mid-DPU. This northbound was kind of unexpected. I had thought we were going to get one northbound with the NSA leading. But I was wrong. So I guess we got like at least 5 NS today. So that's kind of cool. And yeah, I don't know how many trains we saw together, but I think we did saw 20 the whole trip in 24 hours. So that was kind of good. So yeah, surprise thing that was leading was a rebuilt AC6000. That was kind of cool. But unfortunately, today's video will be end off here. Thanks for watching. I'll be seeing ya in the Michigan or State. Or, Buckeye State Wells.